According to Mr. Rennie, it's no secret that at least 70% of St. Lucian students do not succeed in maths at CXE level. He says over the years, the St. Mary's College and St. Joseph's Convent have enjoyed a good track record. However, Mr. Rennie doesn't think that that changes the price of coffee as far as the mathematical problems are concerned. He believes if teachers and students were to swap schools, the maths woes would continue. Against this backdrop, the educator has embarked on a program to help secondary school students excel in the subject through an after-school pilot project conducted at the Gros Islet Secondary School. The project facilitates a pre-test for students entering Form 2 to assess their level of competence.
Children can virtually, when they see a concept, they can just tell you the answer. And that is what Forms 1 is supposed to do, to develop mastery of the earlier number theory concepts in children. Forms 2 to 5 is supposed to be the same subject content. Algebra, geometry, trigonometry, relations, graphs, coordinates, and this, that must be the same from Forms 2 to 5. And if you do that, what you are doing is to ensure that you give the children the kind of foundation that they need. So after Forms 3, children are supposed to be ready to get a 1 in mathematics. In Form 4, all the better. Form 5 should just be for stragglers to get their 1 and 2s. No child should be leaving school without succeeding in mathematics. And the role of the No Child Left Behind program is to bring an end to poor performance in mathematics in this country.
School authorities have applauded the initiative, but they want to monitor the effectiveness of the program. As a result, they've encouraged the students to participate in the after-school program to see how they progress.
As we all know, our national statistic in CSEC for math, in terms of passes, have not been very encouraging. Likewise, Gros Islet has not done very well. Therefore, any initiative put forward by educators to assist our students will be encouraged by our school. The principal and staff of Gros Islet Secondary School do endorse the program put forward by Mr. Rennie, and we would like to encourage our students to participate in the program, take lessons with him, and we are going to monitor the progress of these students.
We also spoke with students who expressed their sentiments on the initiative.
Well, I feel that's a very good thing for us students, so that can help improve us and our marks and stuff. Extra lessons, well, that's always a good thing to have done. So.
Okay, and how have you been doing with math from the time you were in primary school coming up and so on?
Well, I wasn't very good at math, but I'm seeing a bit of improvement.
I think it's a good initiative in our school. Although I do good in school, I think it will improve on our grades in the Gros Islet Secondary School.
So you have been doing well at maths throughout your school years?
Yes, I have.
Okay, so you're one of the more fortunate ones.
Yeah.
Okay, but you know there's always room for improvement.
Yeah, I know.
So what do you think this program can help you do in the terms of the mathematics subject?
Well, I'm not too strong at problem solving, so I'm looking forward to that.
School officials are hoping that the new after-school program will help the students to excel at maths or at least improve their grades. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.